I'll detail you why. Said that if you work in a marsh, you need low-pressure equipment, which we can borrow, loan, rent very cheaply from the state mosquito abatement program, but it is pretty specialized. It's not stuff we have here in town. We'll need equipment operators. Those can pretty much be any qualified equipment operator to help carry out the project.
Yeah, I'm just worried about like what low-pressure equipment.
Low-pressure equipment, so because the salt marsh surface is very wet, you can't take a regular excavator or a dump truck out on it. You would obviously sink right in. And CRMC wouldn't let us go out on the marsh and anything that's going to compact the surface. So those are special equipment that won't.
And we may be able to provide our equipment operators to DPW to assist in that effort, as Carol slide in case it's expected to be a two-week timeframe. And fortunately, it's occurring at the time of year when we're transitioning from fall work to clean up into winter. So maybe if we have some manpower capacity to assist with it. Certainly have the skill.
That's right.
Better capacity.
So that's one of the things that we're hoping the town can help support. We can cut down that 4,800 line item if the town has public work staff that may be able to help us. Construction mats are, again, that estimate may be high, that was provided by NRCS, but when you're working on the surface of the marsh where you have equipment that has to travel back and forth, you have to put something down so that it's not disrupting the marsh surface. Silt fence clearing, seeding, going in and mulching the drag before and after so that we can get in and see what we're doing. So that brings the total project cost to just under $100,000. Of that, we've got 67 plus in the bank from NRCS. We have 8,000. NRCS counts in-kind support, so that 8,000 our Conservation Commission in-kind support goes right to that line item. We have a remaining need of $22,000. That could be partially offset by help from public works staff if that's available. That would bring that down. And we have been asked to submit a proposal to CRMC's Coastal and Estuarine Habitat Restoration Trust Fund program this coming Friday to ask for whatever's left. So basically, working with NRCS, with the town, asking for your support, we're hoping we can figure out what the town can contribute and ask that you would be willing to help support our proposal going forward to CRMC for whatever the remaining funds needed are. And that's it.
So, yeah, so I think it was fortunate that Mike was on council when the original presentation was made in, I think, December of 2006.
Six.
So it was back a little over 3 years.
It's taken a little while.
But great project, obviously. The great swamp is one of our unique natural wonders on the island. We don't want to see it degraded any further by the march of the Phragmites, you know, across the swamp. We're fortunate that the Carolyn slide indicates $90,000 of the total cost to get this work done. And at this point, there's been no financial contribution by the town, nor do we expect that there will be one.
That's right.
Hoping to utilize some of the kind of support of the DPW staff, as well as what the Conservation Commission has done.
Questions?
No, seems very well finessed. Thought through scientific.
All right, okay. So, do you have a meeting this week? Next week?
Actually, our meeting in January was canceled.
The CRMC?
I'm sorry, the Conservation Commission. We have a proposal that we'd like to submit to CRMC this coming Friday. We have a meeting with NRCS to finalize some things. Of course, we make that proposal tomorrow. So, Bruce has been great in helping us with the details in a hurry. I would hope that we might ask the town for a letter of support to go along with that.
Yeah, I'm always in support of offering our support for other people giving Conservation Commission money. We should have it done.
We need a motion to have the town draft a letter of support for the Conservation Commission to go for the grant from CRMC.
Second. Just one point of discussion. Your remaining needs is $22,440. You're saying that you're looking for other funding sources.
besides the town for that, and some of that will be in-kind support.
So that $22,000 is what we'd like to ask CROC for in this proposal that's going in on Friday.
Okay.
The total equipment operator needs amount to just under $5,000. So whatever the town can help us with in that regard, and that's going to depend on availability and such, we can reduce the amount we need to ask CROC for.
So with the town's letter of support, we receive this grant and in-kind support at a time when staff will permit it, we need this done for.
Really, this, and the timing's okay, this timing's between fall and year. So it's worth the timing for that.
We have to figure out what our schedule's going to be for the remainder of the year, but any weekend site loss is that time of year. It's proportionate that it's not a summer project when a lot of downtime due to vacation schedules. Obviously, this for staff, the time that we need to do the quick thought and work. So that works out well.
We also have, NRCS provides all of the onsite management oversight, so they're there to direct everything. It's really just someone who can operate for them.
So we have a motion on the floor, is that second, all in favor?
Aye.